The National Drug Authority has registered several complaints on misleading adverts of drinks that purportedly boost health, moreover without any medical proof. The Uganda Communications Commission, National Drug Authority and Uganda National Bureau of Standards have separately come under fire in the past over this, accused of failing to perform their roles, hence abetting misinformation. The National Drug Authority says manufacturers of these drinks usually present them as non-alcoholic carbonated drinks to obtain the quality marks from Uganda National Bureau of Standards. Officials, however, say later these same manufacturers advertise the products as medicinal so as to obtain market share.
The biggest challenge we have are the energy drinks, soft drinks, who go to our colleagues at UNBS. They get a Q mark and are allowed onto the market as soft drinks or energy drinks. When they get onto the market, they start promoting themselves with medicinal creams, with treatment creams, and that is illegal.
Patricia Bagene insists that whereas UNBS is mandated with certifying these products, it is incumbent upon the National Drug Authority to confirm whether these drinks are indeed medicinal or not.
You cannot claim that UNBS is going to look after everything. No, our mandate is clear. If you are doing a soft drink, if you are doing a fruit juice, and we have Uganda standards for them, we can help you. The moment you want to do a medicinal product, you must go to National Drug Authority, and we shall send you there.
The two regulating bodies, together with the Uganda Communications Commission, say for a media house to accept the advertisement of a product, it must first verify that it is cleared by both the standards body, UNBS, and the regulator of drugs, National Drug Authority.
The expectation here is that no broadcaster should run an advert that has therapeutic claims without that advert being approved by the National Drug Authority. This is being done to protect the general public so that they are not duped into taking drug-related things that can be detrimental to their health and harmful to their health.
We cannot allow anyone to go misleading the public about drug information. If people get issues from consuming those products, and they get the impact.
Section 33, Clause 1 of the National Drug Policy and Authority Act, CAP 206, prohibits the advertisement and publication of information that is calculated to promote the use of a drug for the prevention of treatment of any disease or relating to enhancing human potency. In addition, Section 5, Clause 1 to Clause 5 in the Food and Drugs Act, CAP 278, prohibits the false labeling of advertisement of food or drug. Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the News.